Good morning, guys. Happy 1st of February. It's Wednesday. I just thought I would do an update because, you know, I tend to post quite a lot and people may be wondering what's happened to me. Well, I haven't been very well, and there's been no more paranormal activity, and I'm sorry about the glare, I can see it here. I'm sorry, I have to have lights on and then in the bathroom, and I have to wear glasses, otherwise I can't see you. Anyway, as I was saying, since the paranormal activity in my hair, sit back, mate, no, the glare's still bad, I'll just have to go like that. I have been unwell. In fact, I woke up at 7:55 something this morning. That's not like me. I normally am up at 6:15. I just feel really tired. I feel really off in my gut. But as I said, since I'm catching that paranormal activity, there's been nothing. And I had a psychic who said to me, remember I told you I got some funding, and with that funding I've been able to employ some different people, and one of that was going to be a housekeeper, and to look after housework. And as soon as I asked him, and now this won't go back a bit, Jim, the psychic had already sent me the message that the paranormal activity was caused by a male spirit who was warning me that someone was being dishonest. Did I get any visitors? And I don't. Are you having any work done? And I was. So back to this house cleaner. And I then emailed him and asked for a police check. And suddenly, within minutes of me doing that, he rang to say that his mother was sick and he couldn't do it. He had to be with family for 2 weeks. Now, if he really wanted the job, I would have said I could wait 2 weeks and the job's yours, because I've waited this long and this package is over 2 years. So it didn't matter. So something was very sus about that. Then on Saturday, this is a very upsetting for me to tell you. I have a neighbour who, he's in a wheelchair and his lower limbs are amputated, and he moved in here about couple of months after I moved in, and I moved in here December 2021. And anyway, when he moved in, I felt very sorry for him, and I didn't know anyone in this block of units, so I introduced myself, gave my number, and I found out that his amputation was caused by drugs. So I tried to invite him to NA because I was still going to NA at the time. Anyway, to cut a long story short, he told me he was clean, but when he went to the toilet, I saw some paraphernalia in his bin. The next day he was supposed to come to my place, but he messaged me and said his head was in the wrong place and he couldn't have a friendship. A few weeks later, I got these sick texts to come over and have sex with him. Well, I ignored them and I haven't spoken to him in a year. And then on Saturday, I get texts, vile texts, saying, oh, I've got the place to myself, come over and we'll have sex. So I'm wondering whether the paranormal activity was also about that. And that was just my phone messaging me, so don't worry about it. So maybe because I said don't ever contact me again, and again blocked the number because it was a strange number that came up, maybe that's why the paranormal activities calmed down. Because nothing's happened at all this last few nights. My torch has been fine. There's been no motion detector hasn't come on. I even thought maybe the batteries were flat and put my hand in front of it, but no, they're fine. And I won't be on channel tomorrow. Sorry, I'm trying to take my glasses off temporarily. I can't see you, so I'm just trying to stop glare. I won't be on tomorrow because I'll be having my Vivadol injection. So anyway, that's just an update. I'm still feeling really sick. I don't know whether that's because the paranormal has made me sick, or the guy, or just the drama that's going on in my life. Because at the same time, my youngest son has questioned why his father wasn't in his life, and his father. And so I wrote my version of events, and I didn't attack anybody. I just said matter-of-factly, I met this way, I went and did this, then that happened, then this happened, then rah rah rah. And instead of writing his version of events, they just attacked me. So my son said, you don't talk about my mother this way. And he has defended me and just cut off that man out of his life. So I have had some toxic, sorry, I just can't see you guys. I have had toxicity and drama around me, and maybe that's why I've had the paranormal activity. I asked the psychic who said that it was warning me that someone was being dishonest, was it my husband Rob? And she said, yes, I think so. And interestingly, the motion detector is pointed right at his urn. So I'll leave it for you to judge, but I'm telling you, I did not do anything. And yes, there's a certain percent of my channel is paranormal, but most of my channel is to do with my life and to do with trying to help you with addiction, with traumas, and I'm hoping to do one on pain very soon. So lots of love. Hasn't the year already gone? We can't get it back. January 2023 is gone. Whoosh! Anyway, cherish every moment, because life is just moving rapidly now. Cherish every moment. Love the best you can. And remember, every life matters, including yours. Love you. Bye. Thanks for watching, Jim. Bye.